Hey guys, one more little tip on how to be successful after your boarded trade. Remember that the boarded trade is, we don't teach it as like a series of tips or tricks. We teach our trading as a lifestyle. So what we want you to do is we want you to also treat trading as a lifestyle. So a lot of people will say, well, how often do I spend on trading? Spend the whole day. Meaning, what are you doing right now? Right now you're watching this video. Well, your dog should then maybe be in a downstay or place while you're watching the video, because chances are you're in the house. You might be on a walk right now listening to this video, but say you're in the house, you're in front of your computer, you're watching TV, you're reading a book, you're on social media, you're preparing, eating, cleaning up of your family meals or a meal for yourself. Your dog should be in a downstay or place. Do it literally as a lifestyle. You're driving in the car, the dog should be lying down, relaxing. That's really, really important. So it's really, really important for folks to understand that trading is a lifestyle, not just like something we do occasionally. And then the dog just goes, oh, this is how I behave. This is how I behave in all these situations. What folks do historically is they're a little bit lax and they let a lot of things slide. But then, like, say when friends come over, they're like, oh, we need to tighten up the ship. Instead, always have the ship nice and tight. Why? Then your dog goes, this is what I do. I just listen. That's very, very important. Treat training like a lifestyle, not a series of tricks that you're doing with your dog. Your dog is not something like, let me show off some of its behaviors. It's like, why not just make that lifestyle? So I go to an outdoor cafe, my dog downs, expected behavior. Company comes over, my dog behaves, expected behavior. Somebody knocks on my dog doesn't rush it, expected behavior. So do all these things as a lifestyle, be consistent, also, don't underwhelm your dog. We find that a lot of owners are underwhelming their dogs, maybe because at the pickup, you didn't have to correct your dog as much because your dog was still in the mentality of training in our place. At home though, your dog has the association of, well, I don't have to always listen here. So right from the get-go, as soon as you come home, go right into training mode, and you might have to be correcting higher than you corrected at the training center. Now, it's not always about correcting, but we usually find that owners that have problems, the best way we can troubleshoot is you weren't correcting high enough. Your dog knows this. And as soon as owners start doing that, all of a sudden owners go, oh, that worked. Exactly. Exactly. So another tip to help you be successful after your boarded trade. Madly in love with all of you. Looking forward to your success.